We have something that we want everybody to see, especially you guys. It's a footage that we have, and footage of this special girl who stole the hearts of Singaporeans. Let's watch.
Susan Lim Chiu Im was born on 21st October 1948. The lively and energetic girl grew up with a love for singing, but what made her stand apart from others was a gutsy voice. The little girl with a big voice was discovered purely by accident at the age of 15. The Crescendos, comprising John Chi, Leslie Chia and Raymond Ho, were an all-boys band when Susan, who used to hang out with Leslie's sister, sang her way into the band. The Crescendos took part in the 1962 Radio Talent Time. Although they did not win, the Crescendos very quickly became one of Singapore's most popular bands. In February 1963, the Crescendos created history when they became the first local group to have two songs in English recorded by an international disc company. Under the Philips label, they recorded Frankie and Mr. Twister. 12,000 copies of their records were sold. Singaporeans loved Susan's voice so much that the Crescendos' Mr. Twister even outsold the Connie Francis version of the song. In March 1963, Mr. Twister was number one on a local hit parade and was listed 10th on the Philips International Chart, the first for a local group. The Crescendos continued to make chart success with their next four records, with hits like Silver Threads and Golden Needles. Released in 1964, The Boy Next Door proved to be their biggest hit when it reached number two on the Philips International Charts, beating the likes of the Mercy Beats and Dusty Springfield. All the while, they continued to perform at various charity and variety shows, both on stage and TV, such as The Big Beat Show and Kalong Senandong. In 1965, when popular British group Freddie and the Dreamers performed in Singapore, and in 1966, when Herman's Hermit played at the National Theatre, the Crescendos was the supporting act. Susan was not only talented as a singer, she was a brilliant student who in 1967 entered the University of Singapore. As a freshie at the Dunyan Hostel, the girl with a zest for life took part in campus activities. The pretty, talented and outgoing young lady had many friends and an active social life, and a steady boyfriend she was supposed to marry. Susan seemed to have everything going for her. But on February 8th, 1970, Singaporeans were shocked by the news that Susan Lim had been drowned in the sea off Kemaman, Malaysia. Her body was never found. A month later, Susan was awarded the Bachelor of Social Sciences degree with honors. In 1982, artists from the 60s paid tribute to Susan Lim for her outstanding performance as a singer. Susan Lim may be gone, but a memory remains with all those who knew her.